Everybody, David Pegler here. Look at the European market for April the 26th, 2018. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. This is not a load service, and I can make any direct trading recommendations during the course of the day. What I will do is conduct some live fundamental and technical analysis. Hopefully, we can put together some decently profitable trade plans. Please bear in mind that trading heavily leveraged is risky business, particularly in leverage 50 to 1, sometimes more. On the other hand, this leverage will work for you. Unfortunately, more times than not, as a novice, it will also work against you. So, I encourage you not to trade your hard-earned money until you have a track record of success using your broker's demo. Alright guys, well I had this whole elaborate little Euro trade plan that I was going to do for you, and as I'm doing the disclaimer here, I just dropped about 40 pips, so kind of foils that one a little bit, but I'll run through the analysis nonetheless. And you know, potentially there's a small continuation play during the course of a day. So here's your weekly chart. Alright, and I'll just zoom out a few notches here. Okay, and really what I wanted to point out is this late summer spike of 2008. We're more or less in that same area now, and it's also this congestion area sort of going back to late 2007 as well. So the reason why I'm bringing this up is just because the dollar index is something we've been watching at FX Bootcamp, is that the DEX is coming off at 74 area, which if you go back historically has been a massively important area. And I certainly don't think that the euro is done, or the DX is done heading down for that matter. But a reaction to that area on the upside for the dollar index, and said differently, a reaction to the downside for the euro, makes complete sense of this level from a correlatory standpoint. Now keep in mind, watch the dollar index, because the dollar index is 60% derived from the euro, so it's a massive it's sort of a complementary component of it. Sometimes you'll get more information, you know, sometimes you won't have a great fix on what the euro is doing, so then it's helpful to go to the dollar index and say, oh okay, what's the DX doing? Great, it's doing X, Y, and Z, and that might give you some better insight. And then you can take that information and then throw that on a euro chart, throw the same logic on euro chart, and get a directional play from that. So that's something to look at in your own personal trading, right? So basically what I'm looking for now is enough of a reaction that takes us back to somewhere in the vicinity of this weekly 5MA, which is the marine line pushing up. I'm not looking for us to go all the way down to that line, but certainly go halfway to it, and then I think we'll try and drift up off that again, and that'll look like it's pulled that 5MA with it. Alright, from a dynamic standpoint, the moving averages are all dynamic, so you sort of got to anticipate them to a certain extent. Alright, and if I just switch to the daily very quickly, you can tell now that this is really the first time that, you know, we're pushing a little lower low here after making a lower high. Quite significant. So I'm thinking now that, now admittedly though, you can just see what an important little spot this was here around this 45.20 mark, which we're trying to break now. But definitely the price action rolling to the downside. So I'm expecting us to go and at least fib this rise, which takes us to somewhere around the somewhere in the vicinity of 44.60 or so. This week's weekly central pivot point I have at 44.55. Is that an area to directly get long again? I don't know, but I do think that 44.5 is going to be pretty tough. I mean, just take you to the 4-hour chart very quickly, and you can see this multi-supportive line right here. Now, given the fact that you are coming off lower highs and made a lower low, I would look at that as a downside direction. So I'd hope to see a little bounce here, take that as a second chance opportunity, and then take that to the short side. We're coming off today's central pivot, but I think if you can get back up to somewhere around 44.50 or so, it's worth shorting, looking for that 55 MA. So how's that going to look? How's that going to look on an hourly chart? Alright, there it is, and we get rid of the fib. Okay, you can see the support zone. So what I'll be doing is simply looking for this kind of thing now. You know, taking that swing fib. And the reason why I think it's going to break this time, I'm certainly not looking to short it directly here, that's silly. But why I think it's going to break now is, look, you're coming off the higher lows, so that every opportunity to head up off that daily 5MA, but it's failed to do so. You know what I mean? Now you're just sort of coming off this fib, and you got failure. And now a nice break of that, and a break of these previous little lows. So from a price action standpoint, everything's pointing to the downside, and I would look for a little something like that that pushes you down to around the 44.5 area, basically down to the weekly central pivot. Yesterday's pivots, daily pivots, are kind of tough because the daily range wasn't particularly impressive on the euro. The 200 EMA on the hourly roughly overlaps with S2 there, at around the 74 marks, you got to expect that to be some level of support. You'd long break even before anyway, so I wouldn't worry about that. Looking for a little short, going to the 15 minute, you know, looking for a little short around this 45.50, 45.40 zone, trying to take that down then to 44.5. All right, nothing particularly elaborate there, guys, but I hope you enjoyed the analysis nonetheless. My name is David Pegler. Good luck today, everybody, and we'll chat to you tomorrow. Take care.